Today we're gonna be doing something that I'm super excited about. Growing up, this was like one of my favorite things to do besides fishing. This is like what kind of got me into the outdoors, is going out and crabbing. Hopefully we can do a little catch, clean, and cook blue claw crab, blue crab, whatever you call it. Hopefully we can get some crabs, take them home, have some good food to eat. Let me show you guys kind of how we're gonna be doing this here today.
Over here in this cooler, this is what we're gonna be using as bait. This is like one of the most highly sought after baits in Delaware, like around this time of the year. I guess pretty much all times of year. This is a bait fish that runs through these waters. This is called bunker. Dude, this is some of the best, like everything will eat this, especially crabs. So this is fresh bunker.
And as I said, I mean, it gets hard to find. This is a hot commodity. I called 3 or 4 tackle shops like right before I came here, only one had fresh bunker. So I mean, if that goes to show you anything, I think it's like $2 per fish. Not like completely crazy prices, but you know, it gets pretty expensive, especially when you got skate eating all your freaking, let's not talk about that.
So yeah, that is a bunker, that is the bait. Then these are the two traps we're gonna be using here. So pretty much, I guess you call this like a ring net trap. And this over here, this one's a little bit more expensive. This is a box trap. Pretty much, as you guys can see, you put the bait, there's a little, I don't know if you can see that too well or not, but there's like a little coil, you put your bait under there, and this pretty much just drops into the water like that. This one's a lot cheaper. I picked this up for like $5. So I'm gonna cut the bunker up and kind of tie it on here with some string. I have a, what is this, like a 2 ounce sinker on there. And then just as easy as it looks, I mean, you just drop that down, the crab, you know, crawls in there, starts eating your bunker. And at the right time, I mean, you don't know exactly when they're in there. You just gotta pull it up, hope there's some crabs in there. So that's that. And there's this, it's the same concept. Bunker is in there, or whatever bait, you can use chicken, you could really use anything with crabs. They wander in here, and whether they're here, in the middle, eating the bunker, pull that up. And hopefully bring some keeper crabs up to the deck.
I am excited, man. I have not eaten crabs. The crabs are one of my favorite food. I've not eaten them in so freaking long. They're so expensive if you want to like buy it at the seafood place, like fresh crabs. So if the crabbing guys are with me today, man, this should be pretty freaking cool. Let me stop talking, man. Let's get this started here. There's definitely crabs around. These guys are a little small. Yeah, that's actually, oh, that's a keeper, yeah.
Yes, sir. Get off that.
All right, first keeper crab. We're on the board. Yo, I caught a whole colony. Oh, that might actually be a keeper. I think that's a keeper crab.
Yeah, like the whole bunker.
Dang. It's a jackpot of freaking snails. That's the biggest one so far. Yeah, throw that metal on, dude. I mean. Yep. Deadly dick. Oh my gosh, bro. Oh, he popped it. Dude, I knew it. The freaking deadly dick. Oh my god. Maybe we'll come back for it. Holy, yo, that's a big man. He was chomping on that. Yo, that is like so blue too, those claws. Let's freaking go, dude.
Check it, just make sure. Oh yeah, way. Let me see.
I'm 6-incher. Bang. Bro, is that a whelk? Oh no, it's a hermit crab in there. Oh my god. Bro, you gotta be freaking kidding. You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me, bro. Got freaking Aiden. Daddy horseshoe in here.
Oh, come on, buddy.
Get out of here. That's a cool one, but I don't know. It just looks weird. If this was a human, I feel like it would have an eye patch. Keeper after keeper, we were yoinking them out of the water with these traps. I got a lot of crabs. As the tide came in, I decided to go to the beach, test my luck with some bluefish.
on the SP minnow. Come here, buddy. Oh, let's go. Oh my God, they fight so good. This has to be a decent sized one. I lost one earlier. I had to bring the bigger rod out. Oh yeah, come here, buddy. I had to bring the bigger rod out, try to get one off the beach. I had a feeling they were gonna be on the beach. Woo! Come on, come up here. Put him a good freaking fight. Ah. Come here, buddy. Oh. Yeah. Yeah, it is. Oh my gosh. Woo! Holy crap. Holy crap. Let's go, dude! Ah! Yo, this is a nice one. Bang, darter. Let's go, baby. Oh my gosh. Dude, why is saltwater so fun and addicting? Come here, buddy. Oh my God. Ah, I don't know if this is as big as the first one. I mean, that's gonna be hard to beat. Oh, dude. This is so much fun, man. Beautiful sunset. Slaying the blues. Oh, come here. Bro, I snagged him. I freaking snagged him in the butt. All right, so just size comparison. That is, you can't really see. Let this guy go right here. Oh. All right, let's go, dude. My pants are falling down.
Whew, all right, y'all, back home. Dude, you hear them bubbling. Look at all these freaking crabs in there. I want to take a count because I have absolutely no clue how many we actually got. It was definitely a lot. Oh my God. Let me know in the comments below, like, what do you guys put on your crabs? Because around here, like, people in Maryland love it. People in Delaware love it. I don't know if this is just like a local thing or not. What do you guys put on your crabs? Like, are you doing this? Definitely let me know in the comments below. Yeah, so we're gonna have to do two batches here. This is gonna be the first one. Pretty much I just put them all in there. As I said, I'm steaming them. Wait till they're nice and red and done. It has been a long day, but I am very excited. As you guys saw, we had an amazing dinner. Like, we had the crabs. There was a bunch of crabs that we ate. Spicy sausage, corn, and also some rice too. I think we had rice. So just a freaking awesome dinner. I didn't film too much of us eating it because we just, you know, Kelsey got home from work. We just wanted to enjoy the dinner together. We ate like a decent amount of those crabs. Right now, I'm actually sitting here just cleaning all of them. I'm putting them all in a bowl, like all the meat. I don't know if you guys see that there. We're gonna be straining it. I'm gonna be doing something pretty cool. But really quickly, I just kind of want to show you guys like how like I clean the crab. Like a lot of you guys, you know, want to see the catch clean and cook. So this guy is a male. You can see down here, this thing's a little bit skinnier. If it was a female, it'd be like a little bit wider, like rounded at the bottom. So all we're going to do, we're going to come to this back flap, take that off like that, and then just take the whole back shell off just like that. Now if you're doing this, like if these crabs are alive, that'll instantly put them out. You know, that's like the most humane way I think to do this, besides just, you know, throwing them in boiling water. Right here, these are the lungs. You just want to get all this stuff off right there, take this off. And as you guys can see, there's a lot of like stuff in there. People call that the crab butter. It's just, I don't know, some people eat it. I'm not a big fan of all that stuff. So you could just kind of rinse all that out right there. What I'm gonna do, break this in half, and then there we go. I mean, you could just start picking at it. I'll just show you guys one. So this is the half that I broke off right from that male. Pretty much I'm just gonna take the back just like that. There's so much meat in here. Just kind of take this, all that out right there. Look at that, that's all good meat. I'm just gonna put it over here in our thing. Finally got all the meat out of the crabs. That's a good amount of meat right there. So as I said, the one night we enjoyed, you know, just eating the crabs like normal people eat crabs. But tonight, man, y'all are stepping in to Chef First State's kitchen. We're about to step it up a notch here. All right, so first thing we're gonna do, we got a little pot here. I'm gonna put that on medium heat. Just kind of let this warm up real quick. As that is warming up, we're gonna take this 1/2 stick of butter, drop that into there. Onion. Just kind of get those two mixed up until like pretty much the onion turns like soft-ish.
All right, now let me make a disclaimer that this is probably not gonna be like one of, you know, the most healthiest meals ever. Growing up, this is probably like one of my favorite things like to eat. Just to let you guys know, this is my first time ever trying to make this, so I have no clue how this is actually going to turn out, but I hope that, yeah, man, I don't know. I have a feeling it's gonna be pretty good.
All right, now that that's cooking up, we're gonna add 1/3 cup of flour. Kelsey sneezed over here in the background. All right, and then tablespoon of Old Bay seasoning. This stuff is amazing. Put that in there just like that. Stir all that around until, I guess it's like pretty consistently stirred.
All right, this is the part where I gotta start adding in milk, or this is 1/2 and 1/2. Gotta like stir this into there. Gradually put this in there. Again, this is my first time like ever doing this, so. Not exactly sure if I'm doing this right or not. When this gets like kind of thick-ish, where we pour more 1/2 and 1/2 in. Like see, kind of now it's getting more consistent. Pour a little more of that in. Until we get, I think, 4 cups of the 1/2 and 1/2. That's like what the official recipe calls for here. So I'm just gonna keep stirring here. She's gonna keep helping me pour.
Nah, I'll just put the rest in.
It says like stir to, I think this is fine. Wait, I don't know if I actually said what we were making yet. We are making some crab bisque. If you guys do not know what that is, basically it's just kind of like creamy, you know, kind of like heavy crab soup. Like it's so good, man. If you've never tried it before, definitely give this a try, or you know, just go get some at the restaurant.
All right, we're starting to see sort of bubbles-ish. So right now I'm gonna, we don't want it to get to like a full rolling boil. So this is like perfect time. Go over here, add, look at all that, dude. I'm gonna add that in. Just like that. Kind of work all that into there. Can't leave any meat left behind here. This is smelling so freaking good, man. So we got the crab in there. We got pretty much like, this is almost done. We are gonna reduce this heat right here to low. And then we're just gonna kind of let this simmer for about like 20-ish minutes. But while that's simmering, we're just gonna, you know, keep giving it a little stir every now and then. Oh my gosh, dude, this is gonna be good.
All I gotta say, man, who does it like this right now? 10:44 p.m. Like who does this at night making some freaking crab bisque? Like, who does it like this, man? Definitely, if you guys are enjoying this video so far, please go down there, hit that thumbs up button. It really would mean a lot to me. Let me know, you know, you want to see more videos like this. And you know, it gives Chef First State, you know, a little bit more confidence. We're getting up there, man. Catch and cook master level elite.
I got flour on the lens.
Woo! All right, a little bit later. There we go, man. That is. Dude, that is looking freaking
good. As I said, I mean, this is one of my favorite foods. I used to dip some french fries in it. I used to order this, you know, when we used to go out to eat and stuff. But dude, to be able to make it, like to be able to harvest the crabs myself and just like make this myself, it wasn't the hardest recipe, but this is like so freaking cool, man. So I'm gonna put this in a little bowl. Don't look at that over there. Boom, all right, dude. That is looking like, oh my gosh.
First time ever trying to make crab bisque. This is, I mean, crab pretty much freshly caught. Harvested ourselves. Whew, it smells good. I'm freaking, dude, this looks good, man. That's pretty good. I think I could use a little bit more Old Bay.
Well, some mix all that in there.
I actually really like that, but like, you know when something just needs like a little bit more enhancing of flavor? That is spot on, Kelsey. You gotta try this.
Man. I'm telling you guys, if you've never tried crab bisque before, you got it, dude.
Whew, all right, man. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish that ball up. Kelsey gave me the approval. She thought it was really good. You liked it, Kelsey?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of like what you'd expect. If you guys have ever had crab bisque before, I'm trying to think of like how I can kind of like describe it for those of you who haven't. It's kind of like a rich, creamy, like, I don't know, you get that like salty-ish, like Old Bay kind of like seafood taste. You got the onions, you got the crab in there. It's just, dude, it's like freaking phenomenal. If you guys have not tried it, please, like, I don't know, do yourself a favor, give it a shot. Even easily my top favorite soup, either this or lobster bisque.
Yeah, man, I'm just like happy. That's so cool. This is one of the coolest catch and cooks I've ever done before, because this is like restaurant grade. Like, you could legit serve this at a restaurant.
So again, we are taking it up, you know, to the next level. And this was just so much fun to make this whole video, to go out there, catch the crabs. We got on the big freaking bluefish, and then, you know, to come home, eat dinner the night before, made a freaking fantastic dinner, and then to make this after that. It's just like, this is awesome. Truly living off the land, or I guess the bay, the sea. But yeah, man, I've been having so much fun recently with saltwater. I know a lot of you guys like are enjoying the whole saltwater stuff. And as you can tell, like, I've just been obsessed with, you know, the saltwater. But a lot of you guys, I know you want me to go back fish freshwater. That is going to be happening. Like, I'm not completely abandoning bass, trout, all that. We're going to be going back to the creeks and everything like that. But yeah, for the past couple of videos, you guys have seen, I've just, like, even still now, I'm so addicted. Do you see how those freaking bluefish fought? And just to be able to, like, target so many different species in one body of water. I mean, you can go to that pier, you target flounder, you target bluefish, you can target crabs, and you have a good possibility really at all those right now. And even more than that, like, there's a lot of different species out there that you can target.
Yeah, man, it is like 11:46. It's almost midnight out here. I'm out eating crab bisque.
I gotta finish this video up, then I gotta go edit it and try to hopefully get some sleep tonight. Got some stuff planned tomorrow. Dude, there's so much cool stuff coming on this channel. I'm telling you guys, man, just stay tuned. But again, if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to go down there, hit that thumbs up button. And if you guys want to see, you know, more catch and cooks, definitely let me know in the comments below. As always, man, thank you guys so much for all the support. It truly does mean the freaking world to me. All I gotta say, man, is let's keep this rolling. Thank you guys for watching. See you next video.